I saw you railing into her ass, and I got so turned on.
That's weird. In an interesting choice of words.
Welcome to the party. It's your watch time, friend. If you're seeing me, if you're listening, then it's time to watch something.
What's up, everybody? It's your girl, D. This is Watch Time Friends, where you watch stuff with me, your friend, D, because my other friends wouldn't do it. Today, we're going to be watching Love is Blind Season 5. So basically, there's mess. There's mess, and there might be weddings. So that'll be interesting. I think the weddings are these episodes. So it'll be interesting to see kind of what goes on. Is it going to be the last two couples that we have, or just going to go ahead and finish this out, or we're going to get some more surprises? So anyways, I'm not going to hold y'all up. Let's watch something.
Love is blind for sure.
So the way I looked made you communicate differently.
I like you better without makeup, and
you didn't know what I looked like before.
But now I do.
Now I do, and I don't want to talk to you.
I'm done.
Why do you keep finding freaking towels and freaking floor?
What am I supposed to do with this?
Hang it.
Not that I'm being dramatic about all the. I don't feel like they didn't argue at all. Like, it was literally not a big deal with them at all.
The whole love is blind thing, I get that, but love also needs to eat. Love needs to have a roof. Sometimes love wants to fly first class.
Love needs a private jet. Love needs a mansion.
The things that you were telling me, I wasn't the only guy you were telling.
You were my number one.
I wasn't your only number one.
I just don't understand why he was harping on Johnny, really. Like, we're all talking to multiple people. That's how this is working. What you signed up for. Meanwhile,
I didn't tell you a single thing about Lydia at all, right?
100%.
She was on the other side, like getting in Aaliyah's head, like, this is what Uche looks like. This is what I bought for his dog. So it told me that she was still like upset about how things like ended between us. There were some things that happened in a relationship. I felt like early on, she was a little bit dishonest with me.
I really want to know what Milton's thinking right now.
Can you let me have a conversation with my friend?
Not with my friend. Your friend's all of a sudden.
Come with me, quick.
Can I get 5 minutes?
No.
Let him have 5 minutes.
Hey. You do have to let him have a conversation if he wants to, Lydia. Even though you're upset. He allowed you to have your time with him, with Uche. Now he wants to hear what he has to say, I guess.
That went well.
Did they just leave?
Oh, dude, I heard. Are you good?
I'm good.
Did you rail her? Did you really give it to her? That's my impression of Izzy. Anyway.
I found out that she knew I was being cast for the experiment. What would have been the goal? Did you expect us to end up together? Or were you trying to sabotage?
Like, I feel like everyone else is like, I don't really care. Ruined
anything that me and Aaliyah could have had. To follow somebody around and tell them things about me, like, oh,
that's
Uche.
That's not how that happened on her.
Right, I was about to say, how do you know? That's not.
I don't think
anyway,
that
I don't know.
Lydia wanted me to fall in love and to have a genuine shot
have
at
to
somebody.
Have Lydia's back on this because
so
Aaliyah
you don't think it's your fault at all
you
that y'all broke
fidelity
up
and you were kind of like done about it. Lydia sat there comforting her friend that is dating her ex.
That emotion
yeah,
that
exactly.
Whenever she was comforting Aaliyah
no,
with her face.
Lydia and Aaliyah came to us together holding hands, crying together.
Yeah,
she had known.
Miriam,
she
stop.
Oh, relax.
Wait.
Don't tell me to stop.
I want to hear what Stacey's saying.
Going to...
They were all on the other side, so they can all tell you.
Miriam's bitter.
Of course
she's
you don't
bitter.
Hear. Bitter? You are so
I'm trying to have a conversation.
Bitter for what?
So if y'all want to talk about that.
Nah, it doesn't matter where you go. Yeah, leave. No, don't
what
call
in
me
the
bitter.
World?
You are bitter.
You're so pathetic.
You're bitter and you're
saying
fake.
All the nonsense
huh?
You
you're bitter
said,
and
you
you're
can't
fake.
Say to wait, can you believe this guy?
Do you have a business? Do you not have a business?
No, come back
you're
here.
So
let me answer
fake.
Your questions. Yes, I work in Saudi Arabia. Yes, I have a
f***ing degree from Johns Hopkins University. You can look that up. Oh. I'll read you for the filth you are. Loser.
What would she be bitter about, though? What, because you didn't choose her? I really don't think she cares. Like, bro, you're not that important. Come on now, stop it. And you came here for what? Bro, he just came in here. And freaking... just, they were having a nice time. He just ruined it.
I am thriving, and I am happy, and I'm in love with my fiance.
Yes.
And that's bothering him.
Yeah, it's wild to me. I'm still confused about why he would go over to Lydia and talk about their past as if he's trying to reconcile something. Like, you didn't care about, you didn't want to talk about Aaliyah, the person you were supposedly going to marry.
He said that you were basically stalking him. Like, it made sure.
Oh yeah, he showed me screenshots about like friends saying that I was smoking on his stories or something like that.
Who tracks who's watching their stories, though? And then how would you even like know that to ask Uche? Like, how would you know that she's related, like, knows him? Unless something suspicious is going on.
Look at them.
Now Milton and Uche are together?
I want to know what Milton and Uche are talking about.
I'm trying to be honest tonight, and she blows up at me. Last year, I started getting messages from girls on Instagram saying, hey, I've been seeing her view my stories for weeks at a time. She doesn't follow me. You're the only person she follows. I thought I should let you know.
Then I'm
showing her the screenshots, right? I don't want this to affect like your relationship with her at all.
You don't.
But
so why are you telling
her? I would be a bad friend if I didn't come to you and tell you that she planned for us to both be here because she couldn't let me go.
But then why didn't she insist on being with you then? If that was her whole plan the whole time.
So my mom always told me, like, your perception is like your reality. Like, you know, like, this isn't Pythagorean theorem going on. Like, this is like multi-dimensional calculus. You're in an X direction, she's in a Y direction, and I'm the Z direction.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not even adjacent.
Yeah.
Just like on a different parallel. It's all perception.
Yeah. How have y'all's communication been, generally?
Doesn't matter.
Actually, really
good.
I've really wanted to just like find someone genuine, and I feel like I found it.
So you feel like that's something that's like a lifelong thing between the two of you? You don't feel like you're like in a honeymoon phase where things are like great for right now, but there could potentially be something that goes wrong in the future?
Look at him trying to plant this seed of doubt.
I don't
like that.
Negative perspective.
That's good.
And regardless if like you and her see eye to eye, like we're all on different dimensional planes. This is what it is.
I went into the pods asking you not to hurt her, and now I'm telling you to be careful that she doesn't do that to you.
That's fair.
Don't let her come in between our friendship either.
Uche, best of luck to you, brother.
I want to know what Milton's thinking so bad. Like, is he thinking we're not really like, that good of friends, so it's fine?
I don't appreciate you saying what? To her that
oh,
I think
boy, she's everybody's confronting each other.
I never told her that you said she was a bad person. Red flag right there.
It was more so, how are you going to tell me that you're in love with me? Ask me to be your boyfriend four times. Tell me you're in love with me like four times. And then you're going to sit here and tell me like, I'm so glad this didn't work out.
Because hindsight is 2020.
She loved you in there?
Four times. I counted it.
But you were all dating each other. It's not like she cheated. Y'all all dating multiple people.
I'm calling her out on her shit because you remind me of me. We have good hearts. People can take advantage of us very easily.
Like
Johnny.
Oh God. I'm sorry, I didn't know I was walking into this. I thought I was getting out of the drama bag.
I think Izzy likes drama.
Y'all's stories are conflicting.
Yeah, it's surprising to get a hold of your real personality.
Oh boy.
I hope you guys are very happy together. I really do. Because every conversation we had about Izzy, you didn't tell me that he was one of your strongest connections. You never told me it was Izzy. Honestly, if you knew it was me, you would have acted completely different with him. No, I wouldn't have.
Girl, I think you would have. Because when he dropped you, all of a sudden, you're talking crazy. I don't think anybody owes anybody to tell anyone else who their number one person is.
I had empathy for you, and that's why I'm so fired up, is because you're a shit person. And I feel bad for shedding a damn tear for you.
Well, then.
That's not true.
Number one, she's not a shitty person.
Well, why didn't you propose?
Because
there was
I went from a breakup to going back to him.
We were never together. Don't call it a breakup.
You were never together? Oh, yeah.
You happened to be your boyfriend multiple times, and I never said yes.
No, I didn't.
You told me to fall in love with me multiple times, and I never told you anything back, so please do not call it a breakup.
I never asked.
We can roll the tape.
No, I didn't.
No, we can roll the tape. And to be honest, all that is in the pods. We are out of the pods now.
Listen, that's my friend, and y'all are all my friends. However, I'm telling y'all right now, y'all are all seeing it from a different perspective. Mir, this isn't the time to understand each other. We're not gonna be friends. I'm never gonna look her way, and I hope she doesn't look mine. That's the end of it.
Well, all right then. I don't know, like, I did not come here for this. I thought we were just gonna have drinks and have a nice time. I didn't realize we were all gonna be yelling at each other.
When I tell you about getting so emotional.
Not getting emotional.
Act more like Milton.
Act more like Milton.
You're too big. Look at you. You're a grown ass woman. You're a badass. A great ass job. You make great ass money. You're independent as everybody else. Who cares?
This is such a cute pep talk.
Now, we have a dinner to go to.
Y'all might be late for that thing y'all had to do.
So I'm really annoyed that Chris thought I'm annoyed that Chris thought that I was going against him.
I think it's because Johnny's got in his head, and I think before this she knew it was going to happen.
She's super manipulative.
Like, I don't want to talk about it.
I was just trying to look out for Chris, and I think she's like...
Why do you care?
Because he's a good guy. I got
to know. Well, he doesn't like you.
We're fine. It's not like he
It didn't seem like you were fine when I walked in there.
It was more so about him.
Well, he clearly doesn't want you to look out for him. He clearly wanted to defend her.
Yeah,
coming after you.
True.
So at this point...
I mean, as anyone would do if they were dating someone and you were accusing the person that they're with of X, Y, and Z, then they're probably going to defend that person. So, you know.
I think that you're not really acknowledging the sensitive point to me that it's Johnny.
I saw you railing into her ass, and I got so turned on. I appreciate
That's weird. In an interesting choice of words.
So much.
And for me, I'm getting more and more furious that I'm in the same boat as that.
Bro, she just doesn't want to talk about Johnny, so I think you should drop that.
I feel like the times that you're most passionate and like, I'm so glad to be around you and I love you so much are the times like this where it gets hot and then conflict comes up and it's almost like you've run away from it to come to me as shelter. Where I'm just saying there's other ways that you could show me that you're appreciative of me and not compare it to your past relationships that we just encountered.
Johnny's not a previous relationship. Johnny was a pod chick.
Well, she was over me for quite some time, so I kind of don't feel so good about that.
Why aren't you trying to downplay everything?
Okay. That makes me feel...
Come on now, stop it.
Not
Remember, good. We can roll the tape back, like, just like you said. Chick.
You met me in pod.
She was a pod chick?
You're my fiance. You're not just any girl.
They were all pod chicks. You were pod dudes.
I feel like it's more talk than it is showing me.
Personally?
Mm-hmm.
I'm a little bit more level-headed than you are. I think I'm just like less... emotional, and I'm not saying that in a negative connotation at all.
Yeah, I agree. You're less emotional than I am, but I don't want you to discredit or invalidate my feelings. And it's not because I care about him, but I'm not gonna stay there and listen to his BS because it's not true. It's
just anybody that privilege?
You're right. I'm not saying that you're not right. I'm not saying that I should not let
Showing
him affect
emotions
it.
For
yeah,
me
but it's,
in my life is a privilege.
Interesting.
I am.
It's like if I give you my emotions, you're welcome. But not everybody's like that.
I get that I should not let anybody control my emotions, but it was not because of him that I got upset. It was because of my own self. I should have known better.
Do you think I'm one of the most mature guys still?
The what?
Do you think I'm the most mature guy?
100%.
Yeah, I knew it.
Yeah. It was seeming like you were the older one in the situation.
Milton is burning the house. That's not gonna look good. How'd that look,
sir?
Good?
What was that supposed to be?
You're not supposed to eat the outer stuff for the sausage.
Oh, it's sausage.
Milton?
No. Do you Thank want you. Some? Who's coming over?
Oh my god, Tom!
Oh, baby! I miss you, Miko.
Most important person in my life.
He likes to chew. It's yeah, okay. It's an offer.
I'll take your purse.
Don't worry.
Oh, she's so nice.
What a nice place here. Tell me about her.
So Stacy is loud, sassy.
Oh, wow.
You'll know when she walks into the room. It's never a dull moment. She's special. She's not easy, though. She's tender and sweet and fragile. It's just something about her just makes me want more every day.
I just want to make sure that this decision that y'all are making, that y'all are for sure. Mm-hmm. This is you getting united with someone for the rest of your life. Mm-hmm. And for a guy is, you know, becoming the head of a hustle and all that. And you know that you will always have my support no matter what.
Hello.
Da-da-da.
Uh-huh. I brought y'all some flowers.
And look at
it's
you.
Nice to meet you. Sorry. Texas a hot mess.
Oh my god, so cute.
Thank you. So are you. Are you ready to catch up? Say all the things? Stop. He wants to be a part of everything.
Oh, yes, I already got to meet
him. I'm so sorry.
Sweetheart, he's been all over us.
Are you the official greeter? Oh my god.
You want to come sit over here?
Here's a tissue.
Did you see this?
Yes. Yes, I
First
love it.
First family photo.
I love it.
I'm like, we got so lucky on this to have most of us looking at the camera.
I know.
Anywho, what did I miss?
I thought we were just talking about you.
Seeing me.
Deep inside, I'm thinking, is this really, you know, the person for my son?
I mean, that's fair. Everyone's parents are thinking that. Everyone's family and people that care about them are thinking like, are you sure? Is this for real? Because if you hurt him, I'm hurting you.
Day in and day out, Stacy makes me want to be a better man.
When I say it's real, like it's real. It's put me in a position where I'm willing to take a risk and I'm willing to be vulnerable because he was doing it. Being vulnerable isn't necessarily knowing that there's someone there to catch you. And I've never done that. Yeah, I've never done that.
And you trusted him?
Yeah.
Thank you for telling me that. And
well, this went well.
You to know, yes, he's my baby, he's this, he's that. But I also think of you, because this is you two together.
And you would be her family too.
I don't want you to get hurt, I don't want him to get hurt. Mm-hmm. All I want is just for y'all to be happy. I want to make sure that my son does his part, mm-hmm. you know, and takes care of you.
Thank you so much for saying that.
Yeah. Of course, because
I like his mom. She's so nice. Oh, her outfit is so cute.
How are you?
I'm a hugger.
Hey, Mom.
Hi.
What's up, fam?
This is Lydia.
Hello, nice to meet you. You're gorgeous.
So are you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
My husband, James.
How you doing?
Lydia, nice to meet you. I'm a hugger, too. So.
That is a tall man. I understand now.
Maybe we should just sit down.
But I don't think he's as tall as Milton.
He already sat down in the counter.
You want a drink?
It's probably the only time his feet swing.
And that's my husband, Langston.
Do you call him Milton or you call him
James? I call him Milton because he introduced himself as Milton.
Oh. Yeah. All throughout school, people refer to him as Milton, but my husband is James. He's James.
Little James is getting married.
Little James. We call him Little James.
That's why he didn't introduce himself as that. Why do you want to introduce yourself to the women you're interested in as a Little James?
I did my undergrad in geology with Master's degree.
He wants to separate himself. Wants to be his own person.
After that, I started my career as a geologist back in 2019.
Well, good for you. I'm always eager.
His mom is very,
What's your
I think she's
name
just
again?
Guarded
Bellis
right
Gonzalez.
Now.
Bellis Gonzalez. Okay.
She will Google FBI check you in a heartbeat, and she will know your credit score before you leave this house. Like, she's...
It's what I do.
Can we eat first?
What made y'all decide this is what y'all wanted to do?
He's definitely everything.
Y'all don't got, you don't have a cork screw thingy.
And he's.
Have you ever dated anyone his age?
What?
Have you ever dated
him? No, I have never dated someone who's younger than me.
I was gonna ask that, like, just what? Curious on what a someone 30 would be interested in a 24-year-old.
Where I was when I was 24.
Oh my god.
Do I have the right mindset? Do I really think I was mature enough for a marriage? Probably not.
To be fair, but your son went on a show with 30, mostly 30-somethings.
And they haven't been able to express them their wants and needs in a mature way. And your son did just that.
And talking to him before, though, I mean, we've been out a couple times, and he's definitely mentioned he wants to settle down.
Good job, brother-in-law.
Well, I'll just pop into your noggin and say, now's the time. Today is the day.
I don't think that's something that just pops into your head. Like, you don't just, I mean, most people don't just jump into that. Like, it's something you're actively thinking about, even if you don't tell anybody else.
Let's let us talk to her for a little bit.
All right.
Care.
I always say marriage is like a business. As with any business deal, you should look and see what are the pros and cons, any obstacles. I mean,
so she is a business woman.
So just
that's what I was getting from her.
She's definitely qualified to be,
like, it was straight away. I'm ready for your interview.
You look at a resume and then a person actually shows up and they start performing. That's when you see whether or not they're truly qualified.
He treats me like a queen. He texts me when he's doing an overnight shift. I love you. I cannot wait to marry you. And that's the guy that I'm crazy for, you know?
I want Milton to tell them all of this, though. I know he's not, like, super emotional, express-your-feelings guy, but, like, you know? I reassure your family, bro.
See, right now, this is me. I'm really loving. I am caring. I am loud. I am funny. And I am really comfortable with him.
James talked to us before about pursuing a higher education, getting his PhD. How would you feel
about
that?
It's weird calling him James.
For
who?
Me, I think education is really important. And in terms of him getting his PhD,
I mean, she has her degree.
Support him. He has a great career. He's still.
Of course, she's fine with it.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, she understands.
Him. He's a great guy, and he is really smart.
So, what are your ambitions?
I want to get my dream job, working as an environmental protection specialist.
What do you want to know about James? What do you want to know about his family?
What I want to know about Milton.
Crucial is it that the firstborn child is named James Milton Johnson, the fifth.
The fifth.
Fourth.
No, the fifth.
The fifth.
James.
Oh,
is
right. You're right.
I was like, wait, what?
You're right.
Because I give him a hard time when he works.
Oh, wow. You're right. It would be the fifth.
As a mom, you know, we watch our children and we watch them evolve. And I used to always tell him, you're too tall to be leaning on me all the time. You're going to be someone's husband, someone's father one day. I need you to get to that point and start accepting, you know. And, you know, it's like, don't be the baby all the time.
Mm. I think that's just how it is. Like, you're that, not for everybody, but I understand that, and that the transition from being, knowing yourself with your parents as your parents' child to becoming an adult who is your parents' child is an interesting transition. It's like, weird. Everybody is like, what do I do? And sometimes you just fall back on what you're used to, which is kind of depending on them. But eventually, it gets easier to trust yourself and depend on yourself a little bit more.
What makes you ready now?
Especially when your family and parents are actually a good support system.
Matured. Like, I'm 30. I'm not.
It's like, you already know how to do this. You're good. I can lean on you.
Date around. And it's exhausting. And you get to a point where you're like, okay, I'm just gonna work on myself. And then this happened, you know? And I think it was great because it worked perfectly.
I just don't know. I don't hear it in him. I don't know if I see it just yet. I know James.
You haven't actually had a conversation with him.
I know when he's happy. I know when he's sad.
I think you should go talk to him by yourself. And then
I'm still waiting for James to give me that surety.
I wonder if they've ever seen him head over heels for somebody before. Is this not normal behavior? Have you seen him be more ecstatic? Like, and you're waiting for him to be like that or what? So that was episode, oh, that was episode 8. Why did I say, I thought it was 7 and 8. This is 8 and, oh, okay. Well, yeah, so anyways, like I was saying, like, Milton's sister is saying, like, she doesn't see it in him, but it's kind of like the only interaction so far that you've had with him, with her, and y'all all together is y'all grilling her. So it's kind of like, of course he's not going to be, he doesn't seem like, you know, he's going to be worried about you grilling her at this current moment, but I don't know. Yeah, I'm interested to see, like, have they seen him in love, like acting in love before, and they're waiting for him to show those signs again or what? Like, of course we don't know what Milton is like in a relationship, so you know, this could be normal, this could be kind of neutral, this could be, you know. I did appreciate how he handled the whole Uche situation. Like, basically Milton is like, that's the past, and everybody is seeing things from their own perspective, and you have yours and she has hers. You know, you can say bad things about her and she can say bad things about you, and at this point it's up to me to make my own come to my own conclusions from my own experience, because, you know, right now she's my fiance, and you know, that's cool if you may or may not have went through all those things. She may or may not have stalked you and watched your friend's Instagram stories and, okay, followed you on the show. But it's like the same with Johnny and Chris. We're moving forward now, and if she shows me something different moving forward, then I will move accordingly. But I'm not gonna move right now based on what you're telling me. I'm not just gonna run right now based on what you're telling me happened in the past. I'm going to come to my own conclusions. I'm gonna allow my relationship to be my relationship and not yours. So yeah, as far as Izzy and Stacy, like, it was weird to me that he was just so excited to get onto Johnny, as if she really hurt him. You know, like, as if he's just so excited to make her feel bad and tell her about her, how he feels about her negatively. And it's kind of like, and then you're talking about, she was never my girlfriend. She's just a pod chick. Like, but you're acting like she actually meant something to you. You're actually acting like she actually hurt you or something. Like, the things are not adding up. The math isn't mathing all the way. Like, it's kind of, and I understand if somebody has hurt you and you felt wronged by them, like extremely wronged, not like annoyed, not like, okay, that was kind of messed up, but like someone really hurt you, someone went over and above to make you feel some type of way or said or did something negative towards you, then of course maybe you might get excited about telling them about themselves, I guess. Or, you know, for in my case, you might be happy to only think about doing it. And then you're gonna actually vent and rant to somebody else who's not that person. But I've never seen a man do it towards a woman. And like I said, for him to claim that she's just a pod chick, she was never my girlfriend, you know, whatever. Like, it's weird for him to be that excited about upsetting her. It's, like, weird. So, that's why I'm kind of, like, making my eyes small at you on that part. And the fact that, like, Stacy was like, I don't like her, which Stacy has a reason to not like Johnny. If she was trash-talking her, if Johnny was trash-talking Stacy, that is a reason to not really care to be around her, care to speak about her, because like from your perspective, you know, you just try to be nice and cordial with this person, and then they just kind of turn around and, you know, basically did the exact opposite. You're thinking that it's all good, but you know, when it comes to finding out that you have the guy that y'all were both talking to, so somebody would have got hurt either way, now you're trash talking me. So it's like Stacy has a reason to, like, I feel like Stacy has more of a reason than Izzy to be, to not really want to fool with her. But the when she said, I don't want to talk about Johnny, but he just kept talking about her. And like, I understand wanting to protect your friends and like wanting to make sure that they don't get hurt. But it's like, it's just weird. It's just like Uche and Izzy were both moving as if the reason for the conversations they were trying to have was because they still care about that other, the person they were with, or they still feel hurt about what happened with the person they were with. And it's like in both situations, like Izzy's like, I'm just looking out for Chris, and then Uche's like, I'm just looking out for Milton. But it's like, are you really? Because it's giving, you're telling me your story, and it's not really feeling like you're trying to protect me. It's feeling like you're trying to, I don't know, for Uche, I'm, it's like he was trying to convince Milton to break up with it, with Lydia. Like, are you sure you don't think this is just a honeymoon phase? Like, maybe, but let me figure that out for myself. And then, yeah, it felt like maybe this is because Uche is like an attorney, so he kind of says things, I don't want to say more eloquent, but just different than Izzy does. Like, it felt almost as if the words Uche was saying was more, when he was talking to Milton, was like, I'm looking out for you, bro. As opposed to when Izzy was talking with Chris, it was like, she did this and she did that and she said this and that and da 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 da. Like, it was feeling more selfish from him. But I think as a whole, it was just, they were both moving weird. And then Uche calling, what was her name? Miriam Bitter? Bitter for what? Bitter for what? At this point, y'all barely know each other for real. What you know is what I told you. And yeah, it was a little weird how she kind of wasn't answering questions like full up during the pods. But it's like, this, at this point, the conversation is not about me and my education and my job and my business. Like, it's about you coming here for some weird reason, knowing that you have beef with one of the biggest personalities here, but you came here specifically to speak with her, and now you're just gonna trash talk her even though we're friends with her. You want us to see your side, you won't let me talk. Like, all those women were all on the same side, like, of the pods with Lydia. So it's not just Stacy's perspective that matters, it's all of them. I mean, they all were there with Lydia. They all saw Lydia and Aaliyah's relationship. I don't know for sure, but before I knew about Lydia and Uche being exes, it didn't feel like Lydia's emotions and her wanting to be Aaliyah's friend was not real. And even though she pulled a TMI, like, you're telling me too much stuff that I don't care to know, with Aaliyah after she found out that Aaliyah knew, or that, you know, yeah, that Aaliyah knew about her and Uche, it still was like, besides the little blow up, little misunderstanding argument, whatever that they had, it was like she didn't get like defensive in that moment. She immediately was like, confessed, as if she was like, it was like she was relieved to be able to tell her, or to be able to like not hold that in anymore. And it's like, yeah, I don't know, this is just a lot. I just don't feel like that she just befriended her only because she was with Uche. Like, it's possible that maybe she was like, let me make sure, because she is talking to Uche. But then again, I mean, it's weird because we don't know the timeline of when they started talking and becoming friends. I mean, like, you know, you all are going to talk to each other. Like, at what point is it like, would you say who you're talking to? Or let me be your friend? Or was it we're friends right off the bat and then I started talking to Uche and liking Uche? I mean, we really won't know. I feel like, I hope if that friendship was genuine, that they could get past this, that Aaliyah and Lydia could possibly mend their friendship maybe. But I don't know. Maybe not. Do I feel like Lydia is the reason that Aaliyah and Uche are not together? Not really. It's like Uche put his relationship with Lydia in the middle of his relationship with him and Aaliyah. And the things that Aaliyah was upset about and ended up leaving over was what was happening in the present. Whereas Uche was hung up about what was happening in the past. And it was weird because he would just flip-flop back and forth between defending Lydia with Aaliyah and then completely trash-talking her, calling her crazy. Like, pick one. Like, don't just flip-flop based on what matches your argument at the time while you're talking to me. Like, is she straight up crazy? Then get a restraining order. Or is she cool? Like, make sense. Anyways, it's just a lot. It's a lot going on. Personally, me, I hope, you know, everybody does right by each other. And we move forward in our happiness and live better lives. That's what I'm hoping. You know, I hope the best for everybody involved. So, yeah. This was kind of a long episode, so I'm probably going to do these separately. So, yeah, if I do these separately, then that means I just want to save. I appreciate you guys for watching this with me and sticking it out with me. But, yeah, those are my thoughts. So, I will see you all in the next one, because that's a wrap on this. So, I'll see y'all. Peace.
Welcome to the party. It's your watch time, friend. If you're seeing me, if you're listening, then it's time to watch something.